days ago, I came across the most beautiful performance, exposition, expression of "This Is My Father's World." And I'm going to play that for you. This is my father's world. Why should my heart be sad? The Lord is King, let the heavens sing. God reigns, let the earth be glad. Excellence of mind and elegance of character, that they do what they want to do most, which is to be a perfect person. Did you know that the Sermon on the Mount, which is Matthew chapter 5, ends with these words, "Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect." And how you're going to do that? You're going to do that by spending your time with Him who is perfect, and not spending your time with people who are not perfect and who miss the boat or miss the call. Spend your time with God, not with people. Well, actually, you know that I am saying with both. Spend your time with God the first thing in the morning and the last thing at night. And I believe you will be perfect. And I'm saying perfectly happy. So this is Joy Book number 67, and that ended on the 11th of December, which was the day of the ice storm when we lost our power, our heat, and our light. We've got just one more Joy Book to catch up on. This would be from December 12th, the ice storm, with no electricity, to just before Christmas. I go through these joy books and see what's in here for you, and after that, these joy books can be filed in the museum. And this is during the time that we were in the shelter for 6 days in the gymnasium of the local high school. And the superintendent slept on the floor with us, superintendent of schools, because he had no power. But also that he liked being with us. He liked our companionship. Here's a to-do list, and everything was done on that to-do list, but it didn't get checked off. That was on December the 13th, Saturday, in the shelter. It was a wonderful thing. I say, you know, spend your time with God, not people. Now I'm telling you how nice it was to spend so much time with people. But you know what I mean. You don't? I mean, you wake up in the morning and go to your sanctuary alone and spend your time with God. That's a couple hours maybe, more or less. And then the rest of the day you're with people, and it comes nighttime, and then you spend your time with God again. That though the wrong may seem so strong, God is the ruler yet. This is our Father's world. You can rest you in the thought that though the wrong seems oft so strong, God is the ruler yet. How are you going to remember that if you spend the first thing you do in the morning and jump up and you meet a person and you get off on the wrong track? No matter what, the best favor you can give people is to get up in the morning, the first thing, go alone in your sanctuary and charge your battery and listen to all of the good things that God has for you. I'm going through the pages that were written in the joy book in the high school gymnasium where we were being sheltered by the American Red Cross in Albany. The American Red Cross, they sent up 11 people from Manhattan to help us. And by the state troopers who were there, 4 hours alternating with 2 deputy sheriffs. I interviewed them all, not on camera, but as to why they had chosen a career in law enforcement. And the majority of the answers were my family, my father, my grandfather, my brother, my cousin. And that brought out the best in them. Of course, the worst in them is that they like the badge, they like the gun, and they like the authority on their very low salary. But at least they get a 20 years and a pension. And I did send out yesterday the donations, $50 to the American Red Cross in Manhattan. Correction, in Albany, $25 to the American Red Cross in Manhattan, $50 to the Kinderhook Foundation, and $25 to the high school who gave us the gym, and also gave us the Bible. And getting to know in depth these people, Mr. John Stipples, Mr. John Stickles, the principal of the elementary schools of our school district, Mr. James Dexter, the superintendent of schools, Mr. William Snyder, the principal of the high school, the custodians who helped us so much, getting to know them a little bit in depth, that was a great joy. That was a great blessing. I don't see anything here written down for you, though. I hope you have that experience. I hope you have that experience of going back to the basics. Of losing light, heat, electricity, your water pump for 5 to 6 days. Because it brings out the best in people. To see those Red Cross workers sit at the desk, and as the people came in, to give them what they needed, to accommodate them, to give them what was needed, what was desired, what was convenient, what was comfortable. You'd be amazed the number of people who just came in so they could have a shower. To give the little children teddy bears. I guess I gotta get up. I'm gonna get up. Yep, I'm gonna get out of the sanctuary because I have to show you these teddy bears that they gave the children. One little boy, little Kyle, he was 7 years old, second grade. And he went to the box to get me a teddy bear. And somebody called him, Kyle, Kyle. And the poor little fella, he was doing what was right. And so then they understood. The Red Cross gave the little children these teddy bears to take to their cots and their mats. The food was excellent. They did not provide vegan menu. And the savvy Red Cross worker from Manhattan, Matthew, said that that was a failure on their part, that they should have. Because he's a vegan, and of course there would be a lot of vegans in Manhattan. And speaking of vegan today, I'm going to open my great big box, $120 worth of vegan products that I ordered from Pangea, which is a non-cruelty organization. You'd be surprised. That's Amadeus. I guess he wants his breakfast. Hi, Amadeus. Amadeus, this is a sanctuary and there's not supposed to be any cats in it. There's not supposed to be anything in your sanctuary except you and your builder and maker. God is your builder and maker, and that means that you can't be too bad. You can always be redeemed. What's a good example of that? Saul. Saul was out hauling Christians out of their homes and putting them in prison, murdering them, throwing them into torture. As you know, Nero did, to death, fighting to death, in terrible, terrible, horrible ways. It was a common sport. Nobody could be worse than that. But he was redeemed and became such a true follower of Christ and such a help to us. Well, my goodness, I don't see any accolades for you. I don't see any jewels for you. Because we are up now to the winter solstice. Today is the 26th, that was only 5 days ago. Jim Burness asked me last night on that 2-hour telephone call he wanted to know about what do you mean by the shortest day of the year. And I suppose a lot of people want to know that. Well, it is a wonder. It is a great creation. As you know, the earth revolves in an elliptical path around the sun. And at that point, when the earth is the farthest from the sun, that's when the sunlight is the least. Isn't that reasonable? And when does that happen? It happens on the... This year it happened on the 21st of December. Some years, I think last year it was the 20th. Some years it's on the 23rd of December. What is going on? Well, sun which rises in the east on the winter solstice, the sun rises in the east but the farthest north. Sun here, and we're rolling around on the earth, of course, we're rotating, and we come around to the sun, we say goodbye to it every night and turn our back on it, and then we ride all night, and in the morning we come back to see the sun. Well, that's the sunrise, and so it rises in the farthest north that it's going to. And it sort of rises, it looks as though it rises in the same spot for 2-3 days. That's why they call it a solstice, as if the sun were standing still. You should say this is the sunrise were standing still. And then you've already noticed on the 23rd, 24th, 25th, the 26th, today the 27th, the sun rises a little farther north. And it keeps going that way until you get up to the vernal equinox. And at that point, because the sun is rising farther north in the east, at that point, the daylight equals the night light. That's what equinox means, equal night. And then the sun keeps rising farther and farther to the north, and the days are getting longer and longer until you come to the summer solstice. And that's the longest day of the year. And its sunrise seems to stay there for 2-3 days. That's why it's the summer solstice. And then it starts rising farther and farther south until you come to the autumnal equinox, when the daylight is the same length as the night light, the equinox. And then it keeps going farther and farther to the north until you're back to the shortest day of the year, which is the winter solstice. Isn't God great? And Newton's third law of motion is that a body will continue in a state of motion, in a state of inertia, unless it's acted upon by an outside force. Well, in outer space there are no outside forces, and that's why we have our planets and our Earth. In that continuous state of motion. And if anything touches that or hurts that, you and I are goners. I also want to send James Dunham, who appeared out of nowhere, to see if I was going to be all right with no electricity, heat, light, and water. He said, do you want to go to a shelter? I would not have known. And he said the Stuyvesant Falls firehouse was going to be open to shelter people. And I didn't know. He says, that's all right, I'll come back. He came around 2:30 in the afternoon. He says, that's all right, I'll come back at 6:30 if you want to go. I'll give you a ride, because he knows that I don't drive. I have two great big Lincolns, but I don't drive them. And he came back at 6:30 and took me. And he says, I have even a better place. The high school's going to open. And so he took me to the high school, and that's what started it. See, that's a real Christian. Jim was a former mayor of our village, and I know him from, he's a fellow congregant at church. So that's another $25 that I want to send. He won't take anything. He's helped me numerous times. And he won't take anything. He or his wife Bonnie, they absolutely will refuse any money. And so I sent it to their church, our church, the Kinder Hope Reformed Church, the Dutch Protestant Church. You know that Robert Schuller is a Dutch Protestant church, don't you? The Crystal Cathedral is a Dutch Protestant church, Reformed Church in America, and also Norman Vincent Peale, who changed many lives with his power of positive thinking at the Marble Collegiate Church in Manhattan, one of the first churches in the colonies. Okay, that's all of them, I guess, folks. I love you. This is the errands list. I go shopping once a month. This is for January 7th in the year 09. To get new joy books. You understand what a joy book is? It's your email to God and your email from God. When I turn off the camera, I will write down here what we just did, and then I'll listen to hear what has to be done next. And that's your email to God and from God, but you have to remember that God gets an email. Again, I say I love you, I want the best for you, and I send you positive, powerful pulses that you will get up the ambition and the energy and the drive and the initiative to go by yourself alone every morning and spend your 2 hours or so with God and hear all of that richness and all and the directions, the right path to where that treasure is. God has a treasure put aside for you, and you keep taking wrong turns because you don't think and you don't meditate and you don't spend your time alone till you find the right path and you find that treasure, which has all of the wealth, the success, the attainment, the joy, the achievement, the happiness, the excellence, the elegance, all of the things you've been looking for that have been eluding you these decades. So this is Glendora, alive from her sanctuary, and I hope one day to your sanctuary. Wishing you the best and wanting the best for you. And I mean the best. And start again with the Sermon on the Mount. Ends with, be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect. Don't say that nobody is perfect. That is wrong. That's the devil giving you wrong information, trying to get you lost. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect.
Andy Irvin here. Glendora, Andy Irvin here. Lots and lots to talk about, of course. First of all, I want to wish you a belated Merry Christmas, and I'm glad that you spent the day well in church.
Well, not today, Andrew, just a couple hours.
Glendora, Andy Irvin here.
How'd that start?
Lots and lots to talk about, of course. First of all, I want to wish you a belated Merry Christmas, and I'm glad that you spent the day well in church. And I just understand that it must have been a little difficult without Franklin. But I'm sure he was with you in spirit. And I'm glad you weren't alone on that day.
Oh, I was not.
I ended up working 12 hours on Christmas Day. But I did get something that most people
Hooray! I'm sorry, but hooray.
Blessing in disguise. I think it's had something to do with God trying to help me.
No question about it.
If I keep this up much longer, I just, you know, my health and my happiness will just go down the tubes.
Very well stated.
So
the TV tubes?
It's a good thing, and I'm looking at it as such.
They don't have them anymore. Transistors.
So as of January 1st, I will
circuits?
No longer have a job.
January 1st. I wonder why
so
they did that.
I will have plenty of time to work on your...
That's good.
Show.
He'll come up here and he'll rest and we'll do all kinds of things together, like the character generator.
To what I'm doing now. So I decided I'm going home.
He's all tired out. They've worn him out.
This message will be automatically deleted in...
Glendora, Andy Erdman here.
13 days. You may save the message for an additional...
Again. Hi, Glendora, Andy Erdman again. I got cut off because, you know, the messages aren't that long.
That was
so
cute.
Continue on.
I came
here.
Over to videotape you.
So basically, I decided I'm going to try to sell my house. And,
that's a good idea, if you can.
Yeah.
If you can, Andrew.
Where I don't have to be in the fast lane in the big city.
That's for sure.
And do the things that I enjoy doing.
That is for sure. Get out of the big city.
What I have to do to keep up mortgage payments, which are getting higher and higher.
How do they do that? A mortgage is a mortgage.
Enough of that. You told me something about a camcorder that records on little DVDs. I think that's cute, but they're almost impossible to...
Yeah, he's right.
...to edit.
Yeah, they
so
are.
So I don't have one of those.
But I don't believe in editing.
I understand why you're not getting a computer, but...
I believe you get it right the first time, no editing.
Amazing machines.
A computer is an amazing machine.
Connected to the internet.
When connected to the internet.
Amount of people you can reach.
Amount of people you can reach.
Information that's on there is just incredible. So, for me, it's a very important tool to get the word out.
She's sneezing on her cat now. There'll be Vicky. Victoria.
Sounds very interesting. I didn't get to see Charles Dolan on television. I wasn't aware he was going to be on. But I find that out also very
interesting.
I'm Glendora again. Andy Herzman.
I'm so glad to hear from him.
I love
been
the
a long
jokes.
Time.
It's hilarious. I'm so glad you're still... telling yourselves and making people happy. Did you know, did you hear about the lawsuit against CNN that they lost? Basically, they were convicted of busting a union and...
Good that they were convicted.
We hire over 150 people that they fired.
Good for the union.
I think it's pretty interesting that...
Good for the courts for doing something right.
Against CNN because...
Yes, they do. That's the third good thing.
Shocked to hear that, but also very happy for the people who did about that.
Yes.
What else? Yeah, you know, I will tell you about this today.
Yeah, January 2nd. First day, come up.
This message will be automatic.
Hey, folks, it's Glendora, and we're coming into a new year. I hope you have all your right bulbs. I hope most of all that you go right out the first thing every morning and get your battery charged and here. Mind, the treasure that God has with you that has people.